हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ए वेरी फेमस ड्रामा, द मर्चेंट ऑफ वेनिस, रिटन बाय ए वेरी फेमस प्लेराइट, पोइट, सोनेटियर विलियम शेक्सपियर। दिस इज द पिक्चर ऑफ विलियम शेक्सपियर। यू कैन हैव ए लुक। नाउ वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द लाइफ ऑफ our writer William Shakespeare, but here I want to tell you that no written document is available about him, so that we can know very conveniently about his life. All we know about Shakespeare is only speculation or derived by his writings only. William Shakespeare, baptized here, baptized means namkaran karna. When he was born, it is not known, but when he was baptized, it is known. 26 April 1564. And he died on 23 April 1616. He was an English playwright, poet, and actor also, widely regarded as the greatest writer in the English language and the world's greatest dramatist. He is often called England's national poet and the Bard of Avon. Here, Bard means poet. He is called Poet of Avon, or simply the Bard. His extant works, extant means the works which have existence now, means vidman ya vartman mein jo hai. His extant works including collaborations means jo ve dramas or poems जो उन्होंने कोलेब्रेशन में लिखे हैं, मतलब किसी के साथ मिलकर लिखे हैं, कंसिस्ट ऑफ सम 39 प्लेज। हियर दिस थिंग इज नोटेबल फॉर यू, ही हैज़ रिटन 39 प्लेज इन ऑल एंड 154 सोनेट्स एंड 2 लॉन्ग नरेटिव पोएम्स एंड ए फ्यू अदर वर्सेज, some of uncertain authorship. We cannot claim that they were written by William Shakespeare, but it is our speculation that they were written by him. His plays have been translated into every major living language and are performed more often than those of any other playwrights. They also continue to be studied and reinterpreted. Here you can also have a look on William Shakespeare picture. Now onwards, you must be able to recognize him by his picture. Now again, we are going to study Shakespeare's life in somewhat detail. Shakespeare was born and raised in Stratford-upon-Avon, Warwickshire. That's why he is called bard of Avon because he was born and raised in Stratford upon Avon. At the age of 18, he married Annie Hathaway, with whom he had three children, Susan and twins, Hamnet and Judith. Sometime between 1585 and 1592, he began a successful career in London as an actor, writer, and part owner of a playing company called the Lord Chamberlain's Men, later known as the King's Men. You must note these informations because these will help you in your later life when you will prepare for NET, JRF. At the age of 49, around 1613, he appears to have retired to Stratford, where he died 3 years later. Few records of Shakespeare's private life survive. This has stimulated considerable speculation about such matters as his physical appearance, his sexuality, his religious beliefs, and whether the works attributed to him were written by others. Shakespeare produced most of his non-works between 1589 and 1613. His early plays were primarily comedies and histories, and are regarded as some of the best work produced in these genres. Until about 1608, he wrote mainly tragedies, among them Hamlet, Romeo and Juliet, Othello, King Lear, and Macbeth are very famous, all considered to be among the finest works in the English language. In the last phase of his life, he wrote tragicomedies, also known as romances, which are blend of tragedy and comedies, and collaborated with other playwrights also. Many of Shakespeare's plays were published in edition of varying quality and accuracy in his lifetime. However, in 1623, after his death, two fellow actors and friends of Shakespeare, John Hemings and Henry Condell, published a more definitive text known as the First Folio, posthumous means maranoprant, marne ke baad, collected edition of Shakespeare's dramatic works that included all but two of his plays. The volume was prefaced with a poem by Ben Jonson, in which Jonson presently hails Shakespeare as in now famous court as not of an age but for all time. Now we will move towards to our play, The Merchant of Venice. Antonio, an anti-Semitic merchant. Anti-Semitic means वह व्यक्ति जो कि यहूदियों से नफरत करता है. यहूदी, Jews, JEWS. Antonio is a Christian and he hates Jews. Takes a loan from the Jew Shylock. to help his friend Bassanio to court Portia. Antonio can't repay the loan, and without mercy, Shylock demands a pound of his flesh, as it was the condition. The heiress Portia, now the wife of Antonio's friend Bassanio, dresses as a lawyer and saves Antonio. So this is the whole theme of the play. Now we will move towards act-wise summary. I want to tell here that this play is divided into 5 acts. Now, act first, in Venice. This is the story of Venice. In Venice, a merchant named Antonio worries that his ships are overdue, means they are late. As his colleagues offer comfort, his young friends Bassanio, Graciano, and Lorenzo arrive. Bassanio asks Antonio for a loan. Bassanio, who is friend of Antonio, he asks for a loan to Antonio so that he can pursue the wealthy Portia, who lives in Belmont. Antonio cannot afford the loan. Instead, he sends Bassanio to borrow the money on the security of Antonio's expected shipments. Shipment means jahaz mein lada hua saman. At Belmont, Portia and her maid Nerissa discuss the suitors. Suitors means वे व्यक्ति जो कि Portia के साथ शादी करना चाहते हैं, उससे प्रणय निवेदन करना चाहते हैं. Discuss the suitors who have come in response to Portia's father's strange will. They will says Portia may only marry a man who chooses the correct casket. Casket means एक प्रकार का बॉक्स which is used for jewelry. The correct casket made from 3 possible options. There were 3 kinds of casket: gold, silver and lead. Much to Portia's distress, all her suitors are unsatisfactory. However, she does finally remembers a time when Bassanio came to Belmont, and that leaves her with some hope. Bassanio approaches Shylock, a Jewish moneylender, about the loan. Shylock holds a grudge against Antonio. Grudge means he has complaint or he has some kind of hate against Antonio for his lending practices and apparent antisemitism. Antisemitism, I have already told you that a person who hates Jews. Still, he offers Bassanio the loan instead of charging interest. Seemingly as a kind of joke, he asks for a pound of Antonio's flesh. Flesh means mask ka tukda. If the loan isn't repaid within 3 months, the bond is agreed to, and Bassanio prepares to leave for Belmont with his friend Graciano. Now, act number second. Meanwhile, one of Shylock's servant, Launcelot, wishes to change masters and persuades Bassanio to employ him. Shylock's daughter Jessica also longs to leave home. She wants to become a Christian and marry Antonio's friend Lorenzo. Before he departs to serve his new master, Launcelot takes a letter to Lorenzo that contains plans for Lorenzo and Jessica to elope that night. Elope means ghar se bhaag jana. When Psylocke goes out, Jessica escapes to elope, taking gold and jewels with her. The following day, Bassanio sets sail for Belmont. While Psylocke rages means gussa karna, over the loss of his daughter and the treasures she has stolen. In Belmont, one of Portia's suitors, the Prince of Morocco, chooses the golden casket, while another, the Prince of Aragon, selects silver. Both chose the wrong casket and are unsuccessful. They cannot marry Portia because they have chosen wrong casket. As Aragon leaves, Bassanio is announced. Portia eagerly goes to greet him because Portia already knows Bassanio. Now, act number third. After a few days, Psylocke hears that his daughter Jessica is squandering her stolen wealth in Genoa. She begins to rail bitterly against Christian. Here, the word rail means to abuse. Gali dena, bhala bura kehna. He reminds Antonio's friend that if the loan is not repaid on time, he will insist on the original agreement of 1 pound of flesh. Back in Belmont, Bassanio chooses the lead casket, and in doing so, he wins Portia. His friend Graciano asks for Portia's maid Nerissa to be his wife. Portia gives her ring to Bassanio, making him promise never to give it to another. As Lorenzo and Jessica come to Belmont, news arrives that Antonio's ships have been lost at sea and he is now bankrupt. Then how will he repay his loan? They are also told Psylocke insists on the fulfillment of his bond and has had Antonio arrested. Bassanio and Graciano leave in haste to help Antonio. Portia and Nerissa resolve to follow afterwards, disguised as lawyers, to help Antonio. Now, act number fourth. In the court in Venice, Psylocke demands his pound of flesh. The Duke, presiding over the court, seeks legal advice from the lawyer Balthazar, who is Portia in disguise. Portia pleads for Psylocke to have mercy on Antonio. Bassanio offers his wife's money, which would more than pay the debt. Debt means kurz. But Psylocke refuses to accept. Antonio's death is only prevented as Balthazar, who is Portia, disguised as a lawyer, explains the bond in for flesh, but not for a single drop of blood. So Psylocke cannot collect the pound of flesh. For threatening the life of Venetian, a resident of Venice ka nivasi, will be called Venetian. Psylocke forfeits his goods. Forfeits means zapt karwa dena, kho baitna, dand surup dena. Psylocke forfeits his goods to Antonio and Bassanio. Antonio refuses his share of compensation and asks for it to be put in a trust for Lorenzo and Jessica. He also demands that Psylocke becomes a Christian. broken in submission, Shylock leaves the court. Bassanio and Graciano thank the lawyers who ask for their rings as legal fees. Bassanio and Graciano refuse until Antonio intervenes and makes them give the rings to the lawyers. Now, at the final act, act number fifth. Now, undisguised, Portia and Nerissa return home at night to find Lorenzo and Jessica enjoying the tranquility of Belmont. When their husbands arrive, Portia and Nerissa scold them for giving away their rings, pretending they had been given away to other women. Before long, they reveal themselves as the lawyers from the trial. Antonio receives news that his ships have returned safely. After all, the play ends as the three couples prepare to celebrate their marriages. Thank you.